I'm Kevin Dockendorf, the Coastal Region Research Coordinator with WRC's Inland Fisheries Division. In this presentation, I will provide a brief background on hurricanes and how we plan to respond when hurricane-induced fish kills occur. The Atlantic hurricane season officially begins June 1st and continues through November 30th. The peak of major hurricane events during the season generally occurs August through September. There has been a variable pattern of major hurricane activity since the 1850s in North Carolina. Some decades had few hurricanes, whereas others had numerous storms. And each storm likely had their own effect on fish populations. With hurricanes come several impacts to coastal rivers, including storm surges, saltwater intrusion, flooding, sediment loading and organic inputs, and anoxic conditions where little to no dissolved oxygen is in the water. Most fish cannot breathe in these conditions. So in a perfect storm like Hurricane Isabel in 2003, this happens. Hurricane Isabel rapidly reduced dissolved oxygen in the water to near zero for days, resulting in massive fish kills. As you can imagine, our agency gets a lot of calls when these fish kills happen, both from the concerned public and from anglers. Despite this being a natural mortality event, our agency and anglers are heavily invested in these resources. We will get questions and requests to do something. Fish kills following Hurricane Isabel literally reset the fish assemblage and abundance of these populations, but it did provide an opportunity to research what happens after a massive fish kill. We stocked three different size classes of largemouth bass, which were all tagged before release, and evaluated their contribution over 3 years. We were able to develop a response plan based on these results. The study provided us with tremendous information on how we handle the next hurricane. We all know that it is not a matter of if a hurricane will hit again, it's a matter of when. 1 year after Isabel in the stocking events, our surveys on the Roanoke River revealed less than 5% of largemouth bass recovered had a tag. More than 95% were wild origin and ranged in size from 2 to 21 inches. The largemouth bass population appeared to have rebounded. Our 8-inch stockings made a noticeable contribution 6 weeks after their stocking, yet to a lesser extent throughout the study. 2-inch and 5-inch stockings effectively did not contribute to the population. Stockings were ultimately not warranted as the abundance of wild fish increased throughout the study period. In other words, natural recovery. With no hurricane-induced fish kills after Isabel, coastal bass populations were rebuilding. And then Hurricane Irene happened in 2011, resetting these populations once again. This time, we had a response plan. Safety first. We'll be sure our staff were safe, our equipment was usable, and our access was possible and water quality conducive to sampling. We would assess the extent and duration of the hypoxia and the fish kills to give us a sample site. We would survey those sites in and near the affected areas from that fall. Then we would again survey the fish abundance the following spring and visit those sites again the following fall to survey fish recruitment. And we would evaluate at the end of each step. If natural recovery remains severely impaired, we can consider to continue to evaluate natural recovery as habitat and forage may not be suitable to support further action, or consider alternative management objectives, including stocking subadult and adult fish. Since we had a recovery plan in place, when Hurricane Matthew came along, we were prepared. While the devastation to our coastal region communities was humbling, thankfully the impacts to our fisheries resources were deemed minimal. And we now know that, with no other hurricanes or other disasters in 3 to 5 years, recovery to fish populations will most likely occur naturally. If you have questions, feel free to contact me.